Good afternoon. Let us continue the lesson. Historiography, Indian tradition. Let us continue the lesson, second lesson of history, historiography, Indian tradition. In the last period, we have studied about the tradition of Indian history, historiography. Historiography in the ancient period. And we were learning about the historiography in the medieval period. We have studied about different written sources of history, about different books, just like Raja Tarangini, written by Kalhan, Tariq-e-Firuzshahi, written by Ziauddin Barni, Tuzuk-e-Babri, written by Emperor Babur, Akbarnama, written by Abul Fazl, afterwards Tajul Masir, Tabaqat-e-Nasiri, तुजुक ई तिमुरी, तारीख ई मुबारक शाही. वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट दोज बुक्स एंड द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ दोज बुक्स इन हिस्टोरियोग्राफी. लेट अस थिंक अबाउट बखर. लेट अस थिंक अबाउट बखर. बखर is an important type of historical documents of medieval times. It contains eulogies of the heroes. Eulogies means praising of the heroes and stories of historic events, battles, lives of great men. Marathi bakhars are of various types. Sabhasad bakhar was written by Krishnaji Anant Sabhasad during the reign of Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj. It is an important bakhar for getting information about the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Now, when we think about the bakhars, Sabhasad bakhar is notable. Sabhasad bakhar is written by Krishnaji Anant Sabhasad. He was the contemporary of Chhatrapati Rajaram. He wrote about the period, about the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. And Sabhasad Bakhar is an important source to understand about the rule of छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज. भाऊ साहेबांची बखर डिस्क्राइब्स द बैटल ऑफ पानीपत. अनदर बखर एंटाइटल्ड पानीपतची बखर इज ऑल्सो अबाउट द सेम इव्हेंट. मीन्स टू नोटेबल बखर्स आर देअर रिलेटेड टू पानीपत. फर्स्ट वन इज भाऊ साहेबांची बखर. And second one is Panipatchi Bakhar. Bhau Saibanchi Bakhar and Panipatchi Bakhar gives us information, important information about the battle of Panipat, fought between Marathas and Ahmad Shah Abdali. Holkaranchi Kaifiyat provides information about the Holkars and their contributions to the Maratha rule. There is another bakhar named as Holkaranchi Kaifiyat. Holkaranchi Kaifiyat. From this book, we are able to understand about the contributions about the handouts of the Holkers to the Maratha rule. Bakhars can be divided into various types. There are different types of Bakhars, such as biographies of kings, dynastic history, descriptions of events, history of a sect, autobiographies regarding grievances based on mythologies, and state administration by a king. Now, different types of Bakhars have been noted down there. Bakhars can be divided into many types, just like biographies of kings. Bakhars based on biographies of kings means Bakhars, those tell us, Bakhars, those tell us about the life of kings, just like Sabhasadanchi Bakhar or Sabhasad Bakhar. It gives us information, more information about Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, means many types of Bakhars are there, such as biographies of kings, dynastic history. Some Bakhars describe dynastic history, the history of the royal family, the history of the king's family is the subject in those Bakhars. Dynastic history, description of events, history of a sect, autobiographies regarding grievances. Grievances means complaints. There are some Bakhars regarding grievances. One example has been given there in the textbook. Tell me, who is going to tell the example of the type of Bakhars, just like grievances, complaints, that is Holkaranchi Kaifiyat. Okay, and there are some Bakhars based on mythologies, very very old stories. There are some Bakhars also which are based on very old stories. Those are called as mythologies. And some are about state administration by a king, state management by a king, how the king was running the administration of his kingdom. It is depicted in those Bakhars. In this way, there are different types of Bakhars. And now we have completed the... Hey, who is speaking? Don't speak. Now we have completed about the historiography in the medieval period. Medieval period in India is considered from 9th century to 18th century. This period is considered as the medieval period of Indian history. Let us think about the modern period of history of India. Historiography in the modern period. History writing in the modern period. Now in India, modern period starts from 19th century. In the 20th century, the Indian archaeological exploration and research started under the British rule. We all knew that in that period there was a British rule. The modern historiography starts from the British rule. Okay. And in the 20th century, the Indian archaeological exploration, the Indian archaeological investigation and research started under the British Empire, under the British rule. A number of ancient sites were excavated, dug scientifically under the supervision of Sir Alexander Cunningham, the first Director General of the Archaeological Survey of India. It is important for objective question. Sir Alexander Cunningham, underline there, सर अलेक्जेंडर कनिंगहैम वॉज द फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ द आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया. ही चोज मेनली द साइट्स mentioned in the Buddhist texts for this purpose, for the excavation, for the exploration, for the investigation. Sir Alexander Cunningham chose the sites mentioned in the Buddhist books, Buddhist texts. Harappan civilization was discovered during the tenure of Sir John Marshall. After Sir Alexander Cunningham, Sir John Marshall was the important British officer. In the period of Sir John Marshall, Harappan civilization was discovered. Because of this discovery, because of the discovery of Harappan civilization, the antiquity of Indian history could be traced to 3rd millennium BCE or even earlier. Because of the discovery of Harappan civilization, our history writing reached to 3rd millennium BCE because we got evidences. We got evidences that before the Christ, 3,000 years ago, or before that, there was planned city and developed civilization named as Harappan civilization. Many British officials in India wrote about Indian history. Their writings display strong influence of the colonial policies of the British. In the British rule, many British officers, they wrote about Indian history. But in their writings, they showed strong influence of the colonial policies. We are able to see the strong influence of the colonial policies of the British rulers in the writing of British officers. Three volumes of the History of British India written by James Mill were published in 1817. In 1817, three volumes of the History of British India were published. This was the first book on Indian history written by a British historian. What was the name of the book? The History of British India. How many volumes were published? Three volumes were published. Who was the writer? James Mill was the writer, and this book, The History of British India, was the first book on Indian history writing by a British historian. It clearly reflects an absence of objective perspective. Now, in the writing of James Mill, there was no objective attitude, true attitude towards the Indian history. And there was also prejudice about various aspects of the Indian cultures, Indian culture. And in the writing of James Mill, there was not appropriate total knowledge of Indian history. But James Mill had written the History of British India. He had no too much knowledge about the Indian culture. First thing, and second thing, they were the rulers. British were the rulers. They didn't give proper status or importance to Indian culture. The History of India, written by Mount Stuart Elphinstone, Governor of Bombay, now Mumbai, was published in 1841. The next book related to Indian historiography, related to Indian history, was The History of India, written by Mount Stuart Elphinstone. Elphinstone was the governor of Bombay. Now we say Mumbai. Mount Stuart Elphinstone was the governor of Bombay, and he published the book The History of India in 1841. The period of Maratha Empire is very important in the Indian history. Grant Duff's name stands out among the British officers who wrote about Maratha history. Now, the period of Maratha Empire is very important in the Indian history. Grant Duff's name stands out among the British officers who wrote about Maratha history. He wrote the book entitled A History of Marathas. Who was Grant Duff? Grant Duff was British officer. He was the British officer, and he studied the history of Marathas. He studied about the Maratha Empire and wrote a book entitled A History of Marathas. This book is published in the 3 volumes. Grant Duff's writing also shows the British inclination of condemning Indian culture and history. Now, this Grant Duff wrote about the Maratha Empire, about the Maratha history, but in his writing also, there was a tendency of criticizing Indian culture and history. Now, those British rulers were not writing properly about our culture as well as about our history. Those British rulers wanted to continue their rule in India. For that purpose, they didn't take care, or they didn't focused on the glorious period, glorious things, glorious heroes in the Indian history. That was important. They criticized Indian culture. They criticized Indian history. They condemned Indian culture and Indian history. That was the tendency of those British historians. Similar tendency is witnessed in Colonel Todd's writings about Rajasthan's history. Colonel Todd wrote about Rajasthan's history, and the same attitude, the same perspective was there to condemn Indian culture, to give improper place to the heroes, ancient heroes in the history writing. That was continued. Similar tendency is witnessed in Colonel Todd's writings about Rajasthan's history. The 2 volumes written by William Wilson Hunter on Indian history show a somewhat impartial treatment of the subject. Now, one name has been noted down, William Wilson Hunter. He also wrote about our history, about Indian history, and somewhat impartial treatment has been given by him related to Indian history means he was not too much partial. He was not too much partial compared to other British officers when writing Indian history. Nilakantha Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade were two Indian historians who took upon the task of exposing the limitations of Grant Duff's writings. After some years, the historians, just like Nilakantha Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade, they uncovered the limitations of Grant Duff's writing. We all knew that Grant Duff wrote about the Maratha power or history of Maratha. Now, let us take some questions and answers related to our lesson. With the help of some questions, you will learn more. Yes. Harsh Gavde, listen all of you on your videos. Listen all of you. Harsh Gavde, Gokul, on your videos now, on your mics also now. If I ask you, you have to tell. Now, let us revise. Biography of Akbar written by Abul Fazl. You have to tell the name of that book. Biography of Akbar written by Abul Fazl. Yes, Om. What is the name of that biography? Written by Abul Fazl. Yes. Tell me the name of biography written by Abul Fazl. Yes, that is Om. I can't hear. Yes, Om. Who is going to tell the name of the book written by Abul Fazl and that is the biography of Akbar, Emperor Akbar. Its name. Yes, Deepesh, is it possible? Deepesh Patkar? Yes. Tell me the name of the book written by Abul Fazl and it is a biography of Emperor Akbar. Gokul, we have studied it. The name of the book is Akbarnama. The name of the book is Akbarnama. Now, an important historical document of medieval times in Maharashtra. An important historical document of medieval times in Maharashtra. So many examples we have studied. An important historical document of medieval times in Maharashtra. Yes, let us see who is going to tell. An important historical document of medieval times in Maharashtra. That important historical document is Bakhar. We have studied about different types of Bakhars. Just like Sabhasad Bakhar, Holkaranchi Kaifiyat, Panipatchi Bakhar. Okay. Those Bakhars are important historical documents of medieval times in Maharashtra. Now, who was the first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India? Who was the first Director General of Archaeological Survey of इंडिया, इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एनडीए, इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर डिफरेंट कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स. यस, यू हैव टू टेल द नेम ऑफ द पर्सन ऑफ द ऑफिसर हु वॉज द फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया. यस अभिजीत, फाइंड आउट इन द बुक. सर अभिजीत, आई कांट हियर, व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम? यस, एनीवन अदर? हाँ, लिसन नाउ, आई कांट हियर, आई एम अनेबल टू हियर, यू हैव टू लिसन ओनली. फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया, सर अलेक्जेंडर कनिंगहैम. सर अलेक्जेंडर कनिंगहैम वॉज द फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया. आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया इज द इंपॉर्टेंट डिपार्टमेंट प्रेजेंट डे ऑल्सो. डिस्कवरी ऑफ हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन, डिस्कवरी ऑफ हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन, हु वॉज द ऑफिसर एट दैट टाइम? सर जॉन मार्शल, सर जॉन मार्शल. द हिस्ट्री ऑफ ब्रिटिश इंडिया, थ्री वॉल्यूम्स पब्लिश्ड इन 1817. द हिस्ट्री ऑफ ब्रिटिश इंडिया, थ्री वॉल्यूम्स पब्लिश्ड इन 1817. नेम ऑफ दैट राइटर? जेम्स मिल. जेम्स मिल पब्लिश्ड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ ब्रिटिश इंडिया. हाउ मेनी वॉल्यूम्स? थ्री वॉल्यूम्स. इन विच ईयर? इन 1817. The History of India, published in 1841. Name of the book? The History of India, published in 1841 by Governor of Mumbai or Governor of Bombay, Mount Stuart Elphinstone. What was the name of that officer, governor? Governor of Bombay. He was the governor of Bombay, present day Mumbai. He wrote the book, The History of India, and published in 1841. His name was Mount Stuart Elphinstone. Yes. Now, tell me the important British officer to write the history of Marathas. He was Grant Duff. He was Grant Duff. Now, who exposed the limitations of Grant Duff's writings? Pranav Reddy. Who exposed the limitations of Grant Duff's writing? Who is able to tell? He has to raise his hand. He has to show his index finger. Who exposed the limitations of Grant Duff's writing? Names of historians. Those names of historians are Neelkanth, Janardhan, Kirtane. And second one, Vishwanath, Kashinath, Rajwade. These two Indian historians, these two Maharashtrian historians exposed the limitations of Grant Duff's writing. Now, try to repeat, try to tell, if possible, you have to tell. Dash Dash was the first Director General of the Archaeological Survey of India. Yes. Gokul, are you able to listen? Gokul, on your mic. Gokul, on your mic. Yes. Are you able to listen? Yes, आर यू एबल टू लिसन? कैन यू हियर मी? यस नो? हाँ ठीक है. नाउ डैश डैश वॉज द फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ द आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया. हु इज गोइंग टू कंप्लीट एंड रिपीट द सेंटेंस? ओम. यस ओम, यू हैव टू रिपीट दैट सेंटेंस. डैश डैश वॉज द फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ द आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया. यस रिपीट इट. ओम ओम दलवी. यस इज इट पॉसिबल? इट इज सो सिंपल, वी हैव रिवाइज्ड. यस यस. डैश डैश वॉज द फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ द आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया. व्हाट इज द आंसर? सर अलेक्जेंडर कनिंगहैम. सर अलेक्जेंडर कनिंगहैम वॉज द फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ द आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया. द इंस्क्रिप्शन फाउंड ऑन द कॉपर प्लेट फ्रॉम मौर्यन पीरियड इज इन डैश डैश स्क्रिप्ट. लिसन, द इंस्क्रिप्शन, इंस्क्रिप्शन मीन्स writing on monuments. Inscription means just like stone inscription, copper inscriptions. The inscription found on the copper plate from Mauryan period is in dash dash script. You have to tell the script. Script means style of writing, method of writing, not language. The inscription found on the copper plate from Mauryan period is in Brahmi script. What is the name of the script? Brahmi script. Taj-ul-Masir is a book written by dash dash. Next sentence. Taj-ul-Masir is a book written by dash dash. I am going to tell the answer. Tajul Masir is a book written by Hassan Nizami. Yes, we are going to stop here. I am going to send you some points. You have to write those points in your classwork notebooks and you have to send it on my personal account. Some students, only few students are writing those points. I needed to write all of you. All of you have to write. Okay. Have a nice day. Thanks for listening carefully.